So, Cliff, quite a week this week. A lot of activity, and I guess we should expect such. It is a lame duck session, but there's a lot of stuff on the boards now. Of course, this week we saw a couple of filibusters in the Senate, and we could talk about whether or not we think there should still be a filibuster on legislation. I know you have some strong opinions on that. But it went, I guess, both ways this week. Of
Yes.
course, Keystone XL pipeline. Well, I mean, just lay this out for people because this was not actually a vote, or I guess it was a vote to authorize the permitting of a pipeline. But that seems pretty small bore when you get right down to it, doesn't it?
Yeah, I mean, what you're referring to with filibuster, we had that on this bill and another one, and I'm a big believer that the Senate should be set up as it was set up in the Constitution, which means the majority rules unless we do something to change it. Filibuster is an anachronism from the early 20th century that has stuck around and allowed us to stop civil rights from passing, some of us anyhow, and of course, to President Obama's administration got not nearly as much done and others. So I would like to see that eliminated. But in this one case, to get back to the Keystone Pipeline, the Democrats still currently have 55 seats in the lame duck session before we switch to a new Senate. And even with the Republicans only having 45 seats, they still were able to get 59 votes. So they came up one short. There seemed to be a question at the end as to whether Dick Durbin was going to vote for it, and he didn't, which I found very fascinating, by the way, because you may recall that Dick Durbin was kind of President Obama's proxy on the grand bargain. So had Durbin voted for it, I think my conclusion would have been that this is what Obama wants. And because he didn't, and he was a deciding vote, I come to the conclusion that Obama does not want this.
Well, now that's an interesting point because, the question is that what does that mean, what the president wants? I mean, because he didn't want what in this instance? Because he claimed that he was going to veto it. And then,
That's
frankly,
right.
I have no doubt that he was going to veto it. But it seems to me that, as soon as this vote was taken, everything I started to hear about was that this is going to be a bargaining chip in the future. So give me a sense of what do you think it means that President Obama didn't want to veto it now?
Well, that's a good point. It may be part of what we always hear about that 47-dimensional chess, is it? Where people sometimes talk about President Obama playing the long game. Seems to be true sometimes. Other times, most I found it very not true. Yeah, so I suppose it could be rejecting it now, and then when the Senate comes back in, there are more Republicans. If he were to veto it then, they'd still need 67 votes, and I think I counted at some point and looked at who the different people would be there, and they'd still, with all the Democrats who are going to be there in the next Senate, plus all the Republicans, they'd still only have something like 63 votes. Or so. So they would not get to 67. So it's true, there has been talk of President Obama using it as a bargaining chip to try to get more
Right.
infrastructure spending, and try to turn make this part of a jobs bill. Now, being that we've seen a number of studies that tell you that this may create something like 1,000, 2,000 temporary jobs of the 1 to 2 year variety at most, and something along the lines of 35 to 50 permanent jobs. That is 35 to 50. If you're listening, not 3,500 to 5,000 or 35 to 50, this would be one of those times that if the White House was, well, let's just say it this way, if they understood or were willing to engage in political battle and understood messaging, they could come out immediately and very publicly explain to people that this is only 35 to 50 jobs. Here's all the damage that will be done to the environment. It's not worth it. Hey, but here's what we have, this great infrastructure bill that's going to build up this road and this bridge and, give people a broader vision and, tap into the WPP and all sorts of, things, WPA that went on during, FDR's time. And say, guess what? This is something that will destroy the environment, create 35 jobs. Here I've got an infrastructure project that will update, this country's fraying infrastructure, update us technologically, and provide 3,500 jobs. And I dare, why would anybody in the Republican Party oppose it? And almost dare them to oppose it and make it a very public thing that they are voting against jobs. That would be, to me, what the proper response would be. And just imagine, the press loves the mano-a-mano challenge kind of stuff. They would eat it up. you know, and you'd have, you would change the complete face of what the coverage would be of this. But I never expect that kind of thing from President Obama.
Well, I mean,
sadly.
to be fair, a week ago or so, the president did come out and say, you know, look, there's no benefit to America in terms of the price of gas, and there's no benefit to America in terms of jobs. But again, I was just struck by how many reports we heard about the president wants to use this as a bargaining chip down the road,
right,
which I find a little bit nerve-wracking. But
this
again,
this would play into that, Sam. What I was saying is that, you know, which in a way makes you a bit more cynical that maybe he does want to, because again, you know, or they're just doing their narrative badly once again, and they still haven't learned anything. Because yes, I'll give him credit on saying that, but that's just, that brings us back to the election. That's like saying the other guy's terrible, but then not telling them what you're for.
Right.
You know, I mean, that's only half the equation, which is, no, we can't support the Keystone bill. Here's the dirtiest, you know, type of fuel on the planet. It's going to be in pipelines going through this place and that place in your backyard in Nebraska and here. Who doesn't think that there's going to be an accident? Who doesn't think that something's going to happen that's going to spoil our drinking water? You know, and he would paint a very vivid picture of what can go wrong and then pivot and say, but here's what we can do. And here's what's clean. And here's a way we can actually build a big part of an infrastructure project could be clean energy, wind farms in parts of the Midwest where we need them, quite frankly, solar panels, whatever it might be. And we haven't heard that part. You know what I mean? So with not hearing the positive part of what we will do instead that will be much better, cleaner, and create more jobs tells me that either, A, they're terrible at messaging once again, or B, they do have a plan down the line to trade it for something.
Right.
You know, and I guess we're just going to have to wait and see. But I mean, I'm glad it was stopped, but we do have to all remember that there will be a Republican Congress, a bigger Republican House and a Republican Senate coming in. Yes, he'll veto it if he does veto it, if he doesn't give in on something, and they won't be able to override his veto, it looks like right now. I mean, I guess we'll have to see that too, but it doesn't look like it with the current vote count.
And we should note that too, that this entire sort of Kabuki theater was a function of the Senate race in Louisiana, where Mary Landrieu, in a last-ditch effort, and I don't really see the logic. I mean, the idea that there's a whole raft of voters just waiting out there, like, if only we had the Keystone XL pipeline passed in the Senate, I would vote for Mary Landrieu.
It's the Keystone demographic, Sam.
Right. I find
that
very hard to believe.
She was working
to
get her vote margin all the way down from losing 58-42 to only losing 57-43.
Right. And, I mean, to be fair, you know, Mary Landrieu could also be looking past her time in the Senate. And certainly, if you're from Louisiana, it would be nice if you wanted to get a nice big cushy job to ingratiate yourself maybe with some of the folks in the fossil fuel industry.